We all know that a major earthquake will eventually hit San Francisco. But the real question is, are we properly prepared for it? San Francisco is making sure we are with the new state-of-the-art public safety building.
So the public safety building project consists of four main components. First of all, the police headquarters. We're also relocating the Southland District Station from 850 Bryant. This project also consists of a brand new fire station number 4, to serve Mission Bay, as well as office for the Arson Task Force, which will be relocated in the Fire Station 30.
Originally housed at the Hall of Justice on 850 Bryant, this building is the new home for more than 250 uniformed and civilian employees.
You know, the Hall of Justice was opened in 1960, so this is a 50-year improvement as far as technology, structure, work environment. So not only will it be a great place for people to work, but the technology will make the department much more productive.
When construction began in 2011, there was one clear goal: to make sure that when the big one hits, the residents of San Francisco will still have a functioning and efficient police department. Built to the highest of seismic standards, the building was designed to operate for up to 96 hours off the grid.
One of the breakthroughs from a police department perspective is that this building is self-sufficient, and it's going to be self-sufficient after either a man-made or a natural disaster. If that unfortunate event happens, we'll be able to run our operations from here.
Essentially, no matter what happens, this building and the people operating here that have to serve the citizens is going to be able to continue to function. The department's ability to serve the public is almost seamless.
The building is designed to meet LEED Gold certification, and also boasts two public art installations on the campus.
That means that this building was designed and constructed to a better sense of sustainability. So for example, we're using solar water heaters. We are also using gray water for reuse to flush toilets, and we're using rainwater for reuse at the cooling towers as well as for irrigation.
Located at 3rd Street and Mission Rock, this center also serves the growing Mission Bay neighborhood.
So Mission Bay is a growing neighborhood, and originally the intent of the bond was to have police and fire services to serve this community.
Helping keep a city and its booming communities safe wasn't the only goal that the city kept in mind. The project created 750 jobs in San Francisco, with 82 LBE businesses participating. Overall, San Franciscans contributed 187,000 hours to help complete the project.
I think that it shows the city of San Francisco, the elected officials, the police officers, and more importantly, the voters who paid for this building through a bond vote, that this is what we can do when we all cooperate as a city government and a city agencies, and that this will be a beacon that when we need to build new infrastructure, that they can look back and say, well, we can trust them with the money, we can trust them with their planning because they did such a good job on this facility.
The San Francisco Public Safety Building stands as a reminder of the importance of being prepared, and will continue to serve the residents of this city for decades to come.